Have you heard of the new science of exposomes? As we look at the research on longevity and health span, this word is coming more and more prevalent in the scientific literature. So, what are exposomes? Exposomes refer to the totality of environmental exposure an individual encounters throughout their lifetime, and how these exposures impact their health and longevity. The exposome encompasses external factors, external exposures like chemicals, pollutants, diet, lifestyle factors, radiation, etc. And then there's something called the internal exposures like metabolism, hormones, inflammation, oxidative stress, gut microbiome, and so on. Oxidative stress is an imbalance between free radicals and antioxidants in the body. And then exposomes are also considered to be external factors like socioeconomic status, social relationships, etc. The exposome concept aims to complement the genome by providing a comprehensive description of lifelong exposure history and its interplay with genetics in influencing disease risk and progression. It takes a holistic approach to studying gene-environment interactions over the entire lifespan. So that's the exposome. Now, if I were to summarize the exposome, it would be basically one thing, and that is nurture and nature. Okay, so nature is genomics, and nurture is everything else that influences the genomics. So, does our mental experience, actually influence the gene expression? And in previous videos, I've shared that yes, our mental experience changes gene expression. So we know that stress, of course, causes inflammation, and there are many genes that are affected by inflammation. Stress means mental events like fear, anxiety, anger, hostility, guilt, shame, depression, all of that. And there are very precise mechanisms by which stress actually influences metabolic and genetic activity. That is well known now. But how about emotion? And so stress includes creates oxidative stress and more. Stress creates oxidative stress and more. And I'm just looking at some of my notes because I made some extensive notes for this. And so how does emotional distress and mental activity, depression, stress, act as exposomes that cause metabolic dysfunction, inflammation, and disease? And from all the research, it seems emotional distress, mental toxicity, depression, and stress can act as internal exposures within the exposome that contribute to metabolic dysfunction, inflammation, and disease development. Chronic stress and depression is associated with dysregulation of the hypothalamic pituitary adrenal axis, something that I was looking at as a neuroendocrinologist in my earlier days. And so also chronic stress results in increased what we call cortisol levels, and sustained high levels of cortisol can promote visceral fat accumulation, insulin resistance, and metabolic syndrome. Psychological stress induces inflammatory responses by activating pro-inflammatory signaling pathways and increasing levels of cytokines. Cytokines are inflammatory products and proteins, and they're antibodies like IL-6, TNF-α, C-reactive protein. Chronic inflammation is a key driver of metabolic disorders and also cardiovascular disease. Depression is also linked to unhealthy lifestyle behaviors like poor diet, physical inactivity, substance abuse, which can further exacerbate the metabolic dysfunction that's happening. And yet another factor is the gut microbiome. The gut microbiome composition and function can be altered by psychological stress, contributing to metabolic endotoxemia, which means toxins in the body, and low-grade inflammation through increased intestinal permeability, and something called the leaky gut syndrome. Well, and also now we know that early life stress alters metabolic pathways in key organs like heart and kidneys, leading to dysregulation of energy metabolism, amino acid metabolism, and amino acyl tRNA biosynthesis. Technical terms, but basically, early childhood stress is a risk factor for chronic disease when the child grows up. So, what about positive emotions? Does a happy mind, does joy, empathy, compassion, love, do any of these emotional experiences alter the exposome in a positive direction? And the answer seems to be, from all the research I've looked at, that positive emotional experiences like happiness, joy, empathy, compassion, and love alter the exposome in a beneficial direction. And this is recent research findings. The exposome framework recognizes that internal exposures like psychological states, emotions, and behaviors can impact health outcomes in addition to external environmental factors. Psychological resilience, which involves positive emotions, optimism, coping mechanisms, is now considered a key component of the beneficial exposome that can counteract the detrimental effects of adverse exposures. And positive psychological assets like purpose in life purpose, meaning in life, emotional vitality, psychosocial resources are associated with better physiological regulation and reduced biological wear and tear, potentially mitigating the impacts of toxic exposures. And my favorite mind-body practices like meditation, yoga, and mindfulness can induce positive emotional states and reduce psychological stress, thereby modulating internal biological pathways related to inflammation, oxidative stress, and cellular aging processes. Empathy, compassion are considered salutogenic, which means health-promoting factors within the exposome paradigm, as they buffer against the negative effects of psychosocial stressors and foster resilience. Also, positive emotions and psychological well-being are linked to healthier behaviors like physical activity, better sleep, dietary patterns, which contribute synergistically to overall beneficial effects. Now, is there any evidence, and this is very important, is there any evidence that positive emotions like joy and love mitigate the effects of environmental stressors on the exposome? And based on all the research, it seems that positive emotions like joy, love, empathy, compassion, mitigate the detrimental effects of environmental stressors on the exposome. The exposome framework recognizes that internal exposures like psychological states and emotions impact health outcomes in addition to, of course, external factors. This suggests that positive emotions could counteract the negative aspects and impacts of environmental stressors within the exposome paradigm. Okay, so positive emotions, resilience are now considered key components of the beneficial exposome that can buffer against the effects of adverse exposures. These studies highlight the importance of complementing the genome with the beneficial aspects of the exposome, including health-promoting factors that I just mentioned: empathy, compassion, joy, equanimity, and love. So there we are. The mind-body connection continues to evolve, and today I wanted to share with you what the exposome is and how it influences the genome and what role our emotions play. I hope this is useful.